we welcome you to a football match of considerable significance, great consequence in this part of the world. They've been talking about this one for a while, and they have rolled up to it in fantastic numbers. You should have seen the roads outside the ground in the hour or two leading up to it. It has been bumper to bumper, the traffic has been extraordinary, but the level of expectation is also very, very high. And these supporters who were queuing round the block for their tickets as soon as we knew the date of the fixture, well, now they can't wait for it to begin. And begin it will any second now. And we have in front of us this gloriously imposing arena, absolutely picture perfect for a game of this nature. They appear to be shaping up in a 4-4-2 formation.
Reminders of a golden era in English football, I should add. And it continues to hold its place in the modern game. Playing a second striker runs the risk of being outnumbered in midfield, of course. So with the wider pairing and fullbacks, plenty of running has to be part of their play. And of course, the right service into the box.
So that's got things on the way. Who do you think this turns on, Jim?
Yeah, Kalidou Koulibaly. It's easy to just focus on the physical side of his game, Peter, because he's so powerful and quick, making it basically impossible for a forward to get the better of him in a one-on-one situation. But there's more to his game. He reads the play extremely well.
Diagne! Superb goal!
What a start, and what a contribution from the main man. I had a feeling he might do something given his reputation, but to do it like that, absolutely brilliant. I wasn't expecting that. The understanding between those two plays a big part in that, and releasing the run on side proved the key ingredient.
Senegal have an early lead. Good start. Good spell of possession this, but very little to show for it. Diagne. Keita. Diagne. Shoots! Sticks it away! And they're at it again in double quick time.
And how about the timing of the pass and run? They've worked it before, and no doubt they'll work it again.
Senegal take a two-goal lead, and things should be comfortable from here on in.
Well, unsurprisingly, Peter, the opposition look completely stunned. I'm not sure they can gather themselves.
Floats one over. To the left it goes. Oh, that is lovely footwork. And the finish! It's being played forward. Now, can he capitalise? And it's Gay. Idrissa Gueye. Mane.
reaching half.
He'll hit it! And it's there! And already they're looking to run away with it.
It's a keeper's nightmare, Peter. He just couldn't pick up on it until it was way too late, having so many bodies in front of him.
Three without reply. This is becoming a stroll. Needed a better pass there. And we've reached half time.
Well, there's plenty that can be said about the last 45 minutes, but one thing that cannot be said is that it's dull. One-sided, yes, but packed with excitement.
So off we go once more. So 45 minutes to turn it round.
Diagne really was well marshalled there because he was denied the opportunity to turn.
That's great strength on the ball. Timely intervention. To locate someone up front, done very well to intervene.
Keita
tries to get it forward quickly.
Idrissa Gueye goes looking,
knocks it away.
And no, that is pretty much the end of that.
Ball, who's going to get there?
That's just an example of overcommitting, and they're fortunate for the quality of the intervention. It was vital.
And he's there to cut it out.
Well, to be honest, I think they're all show and no substance. Where's the final product?
The referee's awarded a free kick. Sprayed out wide. Batu Ndiaye gets it back. And now they can launch a counter. He's off on a marauding run.
It seems as if he's just had a momentary lapse and slipped into tunnel vision, because he had good options around him and he failed to get his head up.
Oh, nice touch.
Goes long.
And it's hoisted clear.
Keita plays it short. Yate attempts a clearance.
Great strength, too strong for his opponent.
And the referee brings it to a close.
Well, the scoreline doesn't tell the whole story. They were outclassed in every possible way.
Your reflections then, Jim?
One-sided and only one winner, Peter. The players didn't show enough togetherness and it was weak throughout.
Well, that's it for today. Thank you, Jim, and goodbye.